morning, everyone. Michael Gurley here, speaking of my daily posting on my blog at michaelgurley.org. I've called this episode Ratchet Your Focus. Actually, Ratchet Your Power of Focus. The power behind a ratchet wrench is enormous. It's not simply a speed tool, but one that has the power of leverage provided by a long handle. It can be used correctly and still have poor results. Because the power of the ratchet is in knowing how much power to apply for the results to be perfect. Wait, isn't there a fairy tale about this? Sounds like Goldilocks and her dilemma of too hot, too cold, and just right. Or too hard, too soft, and just right. It takes the right amount of power to ensure that the results are locked as tight as needed to last. Or in the language of tools, it takes the right amount of torque. Torque, and that's T-O-R-Q-U-E, is the tightening force, and it's critically important when working with fasteners that will be subject to some kind of load. The bolt or nut needs to be preloaded with the correct amount of force so that it will neither break nor come loose and fall off. Automakers specify torque settings for just about all their fasteners, and a torque wrench is used to achieve the requirements. There are special tools that can act as a ratchet but measures the amount of force applied to the bolt or nut. These measurements use terms like foot-pounds and newton meters. For application, someone has tested just how much power is needed to ensure the bolt or nut will hold. Not everything has a measuring tool. Sometimes we only learn how much effort it takes by trial, error, and lots of experience. Here's my thought today. Imagine all the forces at work on your daily life. Outside pressures, inside pressures, dilemmas, choices, struggles, family, job, finances, future, past. It takes a lot of juggling to keep everything moving. It is easy to get distracted by the thing that seemingly demands our complete focus. Is it the right thing to put our energies to, or should we shuffle it to the back burner and deal with it another day? Time will tell if you have learned how to make the right choices. We've all struggled with this. Time and again, what starts out as a small problem or project suddenly consumes our entire day, and other important tasks must slip their schedule. Think about it like this. Imagine you're a little toe. Got it? Such a small member of your body. But let it become injured in the middle of the night walking to the fridge, and all of a sudden that seemingly insignificant member becomes the driving force of everything. Not just the moment it's injured, but for hours. We agonize through the recovery. We make sure everyone knows about it. And we limp through the day with a focus that is fractured. And maybe even our little toe. I wonder how can a little problem consume our entire day? That little toe is a driving force and we dwell on it too much. But it's necessary. It hurts. Perhaps we should focus on the little things. Handle it before it becomes something bigger than life itself, like wear house slippers in the middle of the night when headed for the fridge. See, thinking the potential of the little things in advance of a problem helps handle the issue from becoming the main focus. Little forces become big forces. Little problems become big problems. It's often the littlest thing that can control the big things. And the day is lost because we do not consider the smallest things. Yes, there is a scriptural principle in this thought. James writes in his third chapter, verses 3 through 6, he says, "Indeed, we put bits in horses' mouth that they may obey us, and we turn their whole body. Look also at ships, although they are so large and driven by fierce winds, they are turned by a very small rudder wherever and whenever the pilot desires. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasts great things. See how great a forest a little fire kindles? And the tongue is a fire, a world of iniquity. The tongue is so set among our members that it defiles the whole body and sets on fire the course of nature, and it is set on fire by hell. The little things can take control of the big things. Applied it in a little different path. It was Benjamin Franklin who said, "Watch the pennies and the dollars will take care of themselves." This is basically a requote from William Lowndes a few years before, a former secretary to the Treasury of Great Britain, who said, "Take care of the pence and the pounds will take care of themselves." It's ancient logic that is applicable today. Watching the little things in life and managing them well should help you have good results in the large things. Booker T. Washington said, "Success in life is founded upon attention to the small things rather than to the large things, to the everyday things nearest to us rather than to the things that are remote and uncommon." What are you needing to watch over right now? Pennies, seconds, minutes? How about calories, carbs, protein, distractions while driving, last-minute dashes to the stores for forgotten supplies, forgetting to put gas in the tank? Uh-oh, garbage day. These problems are all little things that control our actions and reactions. Control your focus. Ratchet down your attention span to the important things of the moment. And that may be paying attention to the little things, the details, and learning from this experience for a better day tomorrow. Slay distractions. Free yourself from interruptions, says Michael Hyatt. I think if we ratchet down the seconds, we'll end up with minutes. Minutes become hours, and hours can equal days, weeks, months, and years. Let's ratchet our focus, even if the little things or others around you flailing through their own crisis. Be in charge. Don't let people pull you into their storm. Pull them into your peace. Here's hoping you have a blessed and wonderful day.